In the last video, we integrated myQ into Home Assistant to control the garage door. We made the status of your garage door as get notified through Google speakers.
Garage door is now open.
And figured out how to turn on the driveway lights whenever the garage door is opened. But something very important is missing. Perhaps, the coolest part of home automation is giving voice commands to machines and seeing these things operate according to your commands. The garage door, in particular, is a motorized device that involves the largest moving part in our homes. So, in this video, I will open the myQ-supported garage door by giving a voice command through the Google speaker. Okay, open the garage door.
All right, opening the garage door.
Of course, all the courses for making these are still free. Hello everyone, this is the makeshift channel, still doing the garage door project. Let's start right away. As you know, closing the garage door without looking at it can cause safety issues, so I will implement only the functionality of opening the garage door. Opening the garage door is convenient, but it can involve security issues, so we will make some countermeasures here. The most crucial thing among these is a virtual locking device made with software logic. When this lock is engaged, even if you give a voice command to the Google speaker to open the garage door, the door will not open. To release the lock, lock release must be enabled first. If you ask the Google speaker to open the garage door while this lock release is enabled, then it will open. To enable the lock release, you need to command Google speaker to turn on or activate the entity name. The entity name is, by default, lock release, but you should change it in the Google Home app. And it should be chosen as a secret word, only known to your family. I'll name this device the Omega 13, from the movie Galaxy Quest.
Sir, who orders?
Activate the Omega 13.
Also, once this lock release is enabled, it will be automatically disabled 5 minutes later. So you can open the garage door with voice command only in 5 minutes, once it is enabled. However, it would be inconvenient to say voice commands twice during busy morning times. So, we will find a way for you can set specific busy hours of your choice, and only during that times, you can open the garage door with a single shot voice command, without the need to enable lock release. This is a diagram that was shown in the videos of the last season, for a project to transform a normal garage door opener into a smart one. The process of making a TTS notification with Google Speaker was not that difficult. But, I mentioned that, there are steps you need to take to implement a mechanism that opens your garage door with your voice command through Google Speaker. The process is integrating Home Assistant and Google Assistant. In the previous video, I went through the manual setup process, and the process is free without paying a separate cloud usage fee. I have prepared a link to the video at the bottom, so please proceed with the Google Assistant and Home Assistant integration process, according to the instructions in the video. After completing this process, including updating of your configuration.yaml file like this, the entities of Home Assistant will be visible on the Google Home screen. When you give a voice command on your Google Home speaker, the state of some entity in the Home Assistant can be changed.
Okay, turn on the lock release.
All right, turning the lock release on.
Then, you can arrange what should be done in Home Assistant upon the change of this entity. So, even if you don't have the ability to open the myQ garage door directly from Google Home, you can perform a series of commands to open the garage door on the Home Assistant side. According to the survey in the previous video, it was not easy to integrate myQ into Google Home or Google Assistant. And, even if it is integrated, myQ only supports closing the garage door, not opening it. However, I believe that what we really want is to open the garage door with a simple voice command while heading to work on a busy morning. To open the myQ garage door, we will use four Home Assistant entities. First of all, there is a lock release. This guy is an input boolean, and it is defined in the configuration.yaml file. After keying in this entity and restarting Home Assistant, This input Boolean will appear on the Google Home screen because we previously integrated Home Assistant into Google Assistant. We should set the location of this entity to Garage. I will change the name of this to Omega 13. You can now turn Omega 13 on and off with voice commands. Okay, activate the Omega 13.
Got it, turning Omega 13 on.
Then there is an entity called Garage Door. This garage door is defined as a cover, but it is not the real myQ garage door you might think about. This guy is also defined in the configuration.yaml file. It is called a template, and it is a virtual cover just made to process the Google voice command open. So, with this cover template, you can say to Google Speaker, open the garage door. The device class is a window and not a garage, and it is a temporary measure to avoid saying the security PIN that is required by Google Assistant, but not supported by myQ yet. The only thing this template does is enable another input Boolean when the voice command open the garage door is made. The name of the input Boolean is garage door open command, and I will explain shortly later. In Google Home app, its entity name will be just garage door in English, or Chago Moon in Korean, or some other name calling the garage door in your mother tongue. The next entity is the input Boolean garage door open command. This entity turns on when the cover template is requested to open by the voice command. This entity should not be visible in Google Home, so you need to add entity config in the Google Assistant section and set its expose property to false. Let's restart again. This entity will be used to trigger a series of commands to open the garage door. And if you say a voice command to open the garage door, you can see that the input Boolean turns on, according to the definition of the garage door template. Okay, open the garage door.
Got it, opening the garage door.
And the last entity is myQGD, which we integrated from the last video. This is a real garage door, and if you perform the cover open service of this myQGD, triggered by the above entity garage door open command, the garage door will be open for real. Now let's review the configuration.yaml file. It is a part that integrates the Home Assistant into Google Assistant. myQGD should also not be visible on Google Home, so I'll set expose to false. Here is the definition of two input Boolean. And this is a cover template garage door. When you tell the Google speaker to open the garage door, this input Boolean becomes on. Now we will make the garage door open through voice commands in Node-RED. First, we bring in an event state node. The title is request lock release. The entity is lock release. And we change both types to Boolean. And check it's true. Next, we get the delay node. And connect it to the first terminal of the event state node. We set the time to 5 minutes. Then we bring a call service node. The name is reset lock release. The domain is input Boolean. And the service is turn off. The entity is lock release. And we connect it to the delay node. By doing this, when we give a voice command to turn on the Omega 13, the lock release will remain in the true state for 5 minutes and then change to false. Once the handling for lock release is done, we will now create an action for opening the garage door. We bring in an event state node and name it request garage open. Then set the entity to garage door open command. We change the types to Boolean and confirm that the condition is true. To explain it again, the input Boolean garage door open command is not visible on Google Home app. Instead, when we give a voice command to open the garage door, which is a cover template, according to the definition of the template, the state of this input Boolean changes to true. When it changes to true, the first thing to do is to reset the state of this input Boolean to false for the next voice command. So, we name the call service node reset garage open. Set the domain to input Boolean. The service is turn off. And the entity to garage door open command. Then, we connect this node to the first terminal of the event state node. Next, before opening the door, we will check three conditions. First, we will check if the user is at home. We bring in a current state node and connect it to the first terminal of the event state node. And name it, at home. I will set the entity to person.makeshift, which is my name. And set the if state condition to home. This way, the garage door will only open through voice command if my smartphone is detected at home. If there are two users, we can use the binary sensor home occupied, which we created in a previous door alarm video, to allow the voice command if at least one of us is at home. By doing this, when we give a voice command, the input Boolean will be reset, and we will check if the user is at home. If the user is at home, the output will go to the first terminal, and if not, it will go to the second terminal. If no one is at home, there may not be anyone to hear it, but we will add a simple notification message. We will add a delay of 2 seconds for TTS processing. And write a notification message of access denied in the change node. Then, we will copy and paste the Google TTS node and connect it. The second condition is that the garage door must be closed at the moment the voice command is given. Therefore, we will get the current state node. And connect it to the first terminal of at home node. The name is check door closed. The entity is myQGD. And the if state is set to closed. If the state of the garage door is not closed, the output will go through the second terminal. So, we will create a notification message here. We will copy the delay and change nodes together. And name the change node already open. We will write that the garage door is already open. And connect it to the Google TTS node. The third condition is whether lock release is in the true state. We will get a new current state node and connect it to the first terminal of check door closed. The name of the node is check lock release. The entity is lock release. And change the types to Boolean. Make sure the condition is true. Next, get a call service node and connect it to the first output terminal. Name the call service node, open garage door. Set the domain to cover. The service is open cover. And set the entity to myQGD. Getting through these steps means all three conditions are met after the voice command, and the myQGD garage door will finally open by the call service node. Next, let's create a condition that the garage door opens even when the lock release is false, only during exceptional time frames. Bring two time range nodes. The first time range will be set from 7 a.m. to 7:10 a.m. And the second time range is from 8:30 a.m. to 8:40 a.m. Connect the second output of check lock release node to the first time range node. Connect the first output of the time range node to the open garage door node. This setup allows the garage door to open if the time range condition is met while the lock release is false. You can add more time range nodes if needed. Copy and paste the delay, change, and Google TTS nodes. Connect the second output of the last time range node to the change node. Name the change node, not a service time. Finally, write a message that it is not a service time. Hit deploy to finish the Node-RED editing. Now, let's try to open the garage door, based on what we have created so far. The current time is 10:32 a.m., and it doesn't belong to the time range. If I ask to open the door.
Okay, open the garage door.
Got it, opening the garage door.
It is not a service time.
It will say that it is not a service time. So, let's release the lock first.
Okay, activate the Omega 13.
Got it, turning Omega 13 on.
The state of the lock release on the right changes to on. Let's ask it again.
Okay, open the garage door.
All right, opening the garage door.
Garage door is now open.
Yes, it opens well. If I ask to open it again.
Okay, open the garage door.
Sure, opening the garage door.
Garage door is already open.
It will say that the garage door is already open. Let's try the same thing in Korean. In the Google Home app on your smartphone. Among those two entities, press and hold garage door. Go to setting. Select the name. And change it to Chago Moon, which is the garage door in Korean. Similarly, press Omega 13. And change the name to B Mil Jang Chi, which means a secret device. Now, let's do the same thing in Korean.
Google. 차고 문 열어. 네, 알겠습니다. 차고 문 지금 엽니다. 아닙니다.
OK. 비밀 장치 켜.
알겠습니다. 비밀 장치의 전원을 켭니다.
OK. 차고 문 열어.
네, 알겠습니다. 차고 문 지금 엽니다.
You can see it works well in Korean too. That's it for today's video. I hope this video has been helpful. And in the next video, I'll be back with a different topic, maybe it's not related to home automation. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.
차고 문이 열렸습니다.